Today I'm going to show you all of my holiday prep work. Hey everybody, it's Amanda and it's the end of October. I can't even believe 2020's been crazy and it almost seems like it's flown by, but it kind of hasn't. But anyway, we're here in October and this is about the time that I start doing my holiday prep work. And I don't know if you guys do this too, but I thought I would show you the things that I have been working on. So today, the very first thing that I did was I have, usually in September, Rick and I go to the apple orchard. Did you guys see the video? I'll link it up at the top if you haven't seen it, where we went on our date and we get apples. And about this time, the apples start to get a little soft if we haven't eaten them all. So I had a bunch of apples that were starting to go soft, and that's fine. Actually, that's perfect for my apple pie filling. I usually make a freeze ahead apple pie filling for my Thanksgiving and Christmas pies, and I have a video on that already. I'll link it at the top, but let me show you what I did today with that. And I'm really excited for you to see it. Okay, here we go. I have two big bags of apple pie filling. Normally I put it in my food saver. I did do it in some Ziploc bags this time just for convenience sake, but this is actually heading in my freezer, and this is enough for one pie and this is enough for one pie. So I think I got Thanksgiving and Christmas covered. I am gonna need to buy some more if we're gonna make some for gifts, but I actually made a few other things for gifts this week. Okay, so another thing that I make ahead for the holidays is like holiday style breads. So most of the time it's like zucchini bread or pumpkin bread, and pumpkin bread actually uses a lot of sugar. So this year, plus I actually grew some zucchinis in my garden, so I wanted to start with the zucchini bread first, and then maybe if I feel like it afterwards, I'll make some pumpkin bread. So I actually have, this is the last little bit, it's frozen, but this is enough to make one zucchini bread. It's my last one left, and I don't think I have a zucchini bread video, so if you want to see me make zucchini bread, let me know, and I'll use that last one to show you how I make it. Because it is low sugar, and it's actually vegan, so this is actually something that I make for my friends. But this is my zucchini bread. Let me show it to you on the table. You can see that it's wrapped in the festive green wrapping. I'm gonna unwrap it just so you can see it. It's been frozen already, so it's like hard as a rock. And I will definitely thaw it and wrap it in pretty things before I give it as a gift. Had multiple layers on it just to make sure it stays good. So anyway, this is my zucchini bread. It looks really, really good right now, but after I thaw it, I will actually coat it in butter and sprinkle cinnamon sugar on it as well before I finally wrap it up and give it away as a gift. And I need to show you how I do that, how I give breads as gifts, because there's a way you can do it, make them really pretty. So this is my zucchini bread. This is just one. I have the other one there that I've made, and that's something else I've been doing for holidays. Okay, so one of the things that I made recently, and I didn't film it because I wasn't sure if it was gonna go well, was pumpkin cinnamon rolls, and it actually turned out really great. And we made a cream cheese icing for it, and it was delicious. So I made a big batch, and that was just happenstance, but I've got to make sure my husband is not just eating up all the cinnamon rolls in the house, because you know he will eat them. So I went ahead and divided them up into packages of four, that way we can have them for Thanksgiving morning and Christmas morning, and it's already pre-baked. So I'm going to show you what they look like. I don't know what they look like now that they're frozen, but they were beautiful, and I'm sure after they thaw and I kind of warm them up on Christmas Day and Thanksgiving, they're gonna be amazing. So let me show you what it looks like. Okay, so these are the packages of the cinnamon rolls, and I wasn't sure which was the best way to package them, like in one long one or in a square. So I did two different, because this, like I said, was an experiment. I'm gonna show you what they look like. Okay, so not only did I wrap them in plastic, I wrapped them in parchment as well, and I think that worked really well to keep the integrity of the cream cheese icing, but look at that. And this is frozen, guys. I can't believe how good this looks. And frankly, when I opened it, I could smell the yeastiness of it. It smells so good. This is the one that was in the square packaging, which was the corners, and I thought that would go better together as a square. And I think that looks really, really good too. So this is going to be perfect for our family. So there's small ones and there's big ones. That's just how it worked out. But they are gonna be perfect for our holiday breakfasts. Okay, So that is all that I have completed right now. It's just the start of my holiday baking prep work. And the next thing that I am going to do is this. Ginger. I am going to be making my ginger candies, the dehydrator ginger candies. I'm gonna link the top two if you haven't seen that. I made a video on that last year with the 12 days of dehydrating. Everyone in my family loved it, and it has been like something that they've asked for continually. And I haven't made it just because I haven't made it, but I'm going to make a bunch of them for Christmas. Everybody's getting it. Normally I would be giving away some jam, but we ate all of the strawberry jam I made. I have a link for that too if you want to see it. All of the strawberry jam I made is gone. Next year I'm gonna make like five times as much as I think I should make. But anyway, for this year, ginger candies, some beautiful breads, some pies, and maybe even some cinnamon rolls. So tell me in the comments what you're doing for your holiday baking. Are you getting started already? Are you already finished? I have a friend, she's making cheese balls, and I'm thinking about making those this year too. So there's a lot of great things you can make for your family and friends, and I hope you guys are thinking ahead about all the things that you can do. So anyway, you guys have a great day. Thanks for hanging out with me. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.